The next one to do my birthday. I will invite you on camera, okay? Just look at. Just look at that. Hello, beautiful family. You are welcome to my channel. If today is the first time you are seeing this amazing channel, I'm happy to have you here. I hope you take the same way too. Let's get into the business. Yeah, so in today's video, I will be showing you how to clean stockfish or wash stockfish Bazabaza Okoroko. So where I came from is called Bazabaza. I think it's Igbo that call it Okoroko. Okoroko. Or English call it stockfish. So it's Meluza, you know, that is dry. So they call it stockfish when it's like this already. So they call it stockfish in common English language. So this is the same way I will say advise you to be cleaning and storing your stockfish for it. A little salt. Allow it to boil. By the time it starts boiling, take off that water and put another fresh water. Allow it to boil again and turn off the flame. Cover it and let it continue cooking or soaking with the hot water. After that, you just clean it. Like this type that I am selling does not have too much thing, too much dirty. There is no the belly side, like the pool side of the fish, the head, no. So it is pieces and it is all flesh and fresh. So no more to throw away. So we just need to wash it. All you need to do is just cook it. The process of this cooking is not even to clean it, is to reduce the aroma of this fish. For some people don't like it when it has strong aroma, when the aroma is strong, and to soften it. So before you'll be able to soften stockfish, you must cook it. Like seriously, you must cook it. Like this one that I'm selling, it has not spent months or grand before they distribute it. This one is fresh, so they just dry it, they bring it, they dry it, they bring it. So by the time they store it for a very long time, it will become more dry, and it will take more time to soak. So as you can see, it's rising, you know. So you just cover it a few hours. You can even do this one in the evening and wash the body the following day, leave it at the water a whole night. But this one can easily be soaked because it is the pieces, it is not the center one that is this thing. This is also the stockfish, you know. This is the fresh one that is called Meluza that I dry with oven. So I eat Meluza a lot, you see. Yeah, so when you have the one that is this slice on stockfish, you really need to soak it, cook it well, soak it for overnight so that you get soft all to the end. So for this one, it doesn't really need so much time. So just soak it. After a few hours, you just wash it and share it. And the way you love to use it in separate portion, put it in the freezer. So whenever you want to do your cooking, you just bring it up and just turn it, put it together with other of your meat, and you are good to go. So for people that don't like strong aroma from stockfish, all you need to do is change the water over and over again, then it will reduce the aroma. So some people just wash it like this, for example, once they just rinse it, you understand? So, and then if you don't like strong aroma of stockfish, all you just need to do is just parboil it, change the water, parboil it, change the water, parboil it, change the water. You understand? Like this fish that I dry also in the oven, this fish is Meluza. It is the same fish that I'm cooking now, but this is the fresh one. Look at what is happening here. Then at this point, all you need to do is turn the flame off. So family, look at what we got here. See how? So you can see the water has cooled down a little bit. I can put on it now. So I'm about to wash it and I will let you see the ending, okay? So family, I am done, as you can see. I am done, and then look at the deity. I told you this fish has no bone, and look at the clean one. So for you to know the amount of, I will later tell you how much I said this fish I'm to sell it. For you to know, let me remove it from this bigger pot and put it on this this one for you to see how plentiful it is. So as you can see, fully clean. So as you can see, this fish now is fully clean. See, very plentiful. Guess what? If I'm to sell this fish, I sell it for 10 euro. You will agree with me that your girl is favoring you more than I'm favoring myself in this business. If I am to sell this fish, it's 10 euros. This one. And if you are to buy in the store, it is 20 euros. This amount. Understand? See? Nothing. I told you everything is just flesh, 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 and flesh. Nothing. And this, the way I clean up this fish, it is almost boneless. Like, no bone. Almost. It is almost like no bones. It is almost like no bones the way I clean it up. See, it's almost. So my guess, so my family, my fish, place your order. This one, I will just parboil it again with a little pinch of sauce, remove the water, and I will separate it and put it in the freezer. So all the fish you see from the beginning, look at the trash. Even after cleaning, you will see that there is no bone. So the reason why you see this dirty, this many like this, I remove every bones, and I'm type of person that don't eat skin of fish or meat. Even if it's bush meat, I don't eat the skin. So if you are type of people or person that eat the back, is very clean, nothing. All this. That means the dirty that will have come out will be half of this one. Because as you can see, the skin make it more plentiful. You understand? The skin. Because I don't eat skin of any meat. Even if it's chicken, I don't eat the skin. And the skin of chicken, we need it in our body more than the flesh. But I don't eat it. So because of that one, that is why you are seeing the trash this many. Yes. For people that don't care about this skin or the back of the fish, they will just see like something like this, only the bone like this to throw away. So once again, my fish is very clean. So place your order. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoy this journey with me. This is my mushroom that I will use it to cook my ogbono. So I bought it yesterday, will be expired 2 days time on the 1st. So I'm going to use it today with a little bit of this goodness and medicine just to nourish my body. Yes, thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed this journey with me. Thank you once again. May God bless you. I will see you in my next video. Don't worry, some of my friends that know me, not close to me, when they watch this video, they will know that yes, this is a lesson for you. Do you know that when I go to some of my friends' house, in any occasion that I want to help them to cook, they prefer to wash their meat before they hand over it to me. Else, if I wash that meat, God knows that it's only the quarter that will get to the pot. All my friends, they know me. When they see me washing this fish now, they will say, yes, we know that's what the matter be. See you guys. Bye. God bless you.